Once you download Slingshot, the software of Goliath, you're almost ready. You must have a wasteboard under your workpiece before starting work. Then you must screw the power cable stand. We suggest to position it close to a socket for the power cable. The best would be to have a wasteboard bigger than the panel to work, so you can place the power cable stand outside of your working area, directly on the wasteboard. Lastly, you have to place the first ring of the spiral power cable into the hook on the top of the stand. Now you can plug it. Then you can run Slingshot. Choose the project you want to make. We have already set all the cutting parameters and we are ready to start the panel detection phase. On the Slingshot interface, you'll see a step-by-step guide. Now you can place Goliath on the work surface and you must install the spindle protection by simply moving it closer to the robot, since the magnets of the protection adhere to the two metal parts near the bit. Then plug the power cord to Goliath and switch it on. Check also that the router is switched on. Switch on the two sensors by pressing the yellow buttons and wait till the lights start blinking. At the same moment, also the two lights of Wi-Fi and connection on the top of Goliath start blinking too. Now it's time to connect Goliath to your computer. Search it in the Wi-Fi sources and select your Goliath. Fill the password you find in the manual. Once it is connected, you can come back to Slingshot and refresh the list of the Wi-Fi networks available. Select Goliath network and click on Connect. You will need to follow this scheme just for the first connection. For the following times, the connection between Goliath and your computer will take place automatically. Once you're connected, the LEDs of the two tower sensor became steady and yellow. The ones on the top of Goliath become green. Click on the next button and start the calibration by rotating the yellow spinner on the top of Goliath. The LED in the middle will blink a blue light. To start the detection of the tower sensor's position, you must click on the next button. Click again on next and start connecting the Goliath sensor number 1 to Goliath by hooking the yellow pin on the one of Goliath. Please be careful, don't lift the tower sensor too much while they are hooked to Goliath to not unlock the spinners. Place the tower sensor number 1 on each vertex of your working area and press the yellow button to save each position. Every time you click on tower's button, a blue light will blink for a few seconds on both Goliath and the tower sensor LED. It will also appear at each corner of your working area on the screen of the panel detection. Consider that the last corner where you will place the tower sensor number 1 will be the origin of your working area. Once you position it in the last vertex, you have to fix the tower sensor to the panel using the 3 screws. It will help you in being more precise in detecting the last corner. Now you can see all the 4 corners of your working area on the software and you can click on the Set Work Area button. If you recognize your working area, you can proceed by confirming the working area by clicking on the Confirm Work Area button. If you think you need to fix some errors, you can restart with the panel detection simply by clicking on the Refresh button. Now you can take the tower sensor 2 and place it on one of the 2 corners adjacent to the one where you placed the tower sensor number 1. Screw it on the panel and click on Next on the software. Proceed by hooking the pin of the tower sensor number 2 to the one on the tower sensor number 1 and click on Next. Then press on the yellow button of tower sensor number 2 and check that the lights, both of Goliath and of the tower sensor, blink with a blue light. Click Next and now move the pin of the tower sensor number 2 from the tower sensor number 1 to the gray spinner on Goliath. Click Next and select the corner where you place the sensor number 2. Proceed with the Confirm Second Tower button and there will be a feedback from the tower sensors. They will show you a green light, that means that the panel detection is rightly complete. Now you have to select 2 adjacent sides of your working area to communicate to Goliath which ones are accessible in case of change of the bit or to empty the dust collection bin. We suggest you to not select the side between the two tower sensors because Goliath could come closer to that side and bump into one of them. Click on the next button and complete this setup by clicking the play button. Now you can see your detected working area with your project placed in. To start working with Goliath, click on the Calculate Path button in order to create the G-code. When you receive the positive feedback from the pop-up, you can proceed by clicking on the Send to Goliath button. You will be now on the production window and the spindle will lift to its maximum height. That's because it's time to change or set the correct router bit for the cut, based on what you choose on the editor phase at the beginning of your work.